If you are a student, as the exams come closer and closer, do you tend to feel that tension inside you and do you get all worked up? If yes, congratulations. You know why? Because it is this tension and this uneasiness and this feeling that I am not prepared well enough which will spur you on to do better in life, which will make you study more, which will make you more focused on the exam that you are going to give. Even military officers, it is told that when they face the enemy, if they feel that little pang of fear, then that officer is a good leader. If he doesn't fear at all, if he is very bindas about it, what happens, you know? He may put his men into unnecessary risk. So, if you are one of those people who seems to be getting a little tensed up, oh my God, only 3 months left for exam, only 3 weeks left for exam, only 3 days left for exam, I haven't prepared. Let me give you a few very simple practical tips how to face this thing called exam. Now, what is an exam? An exam is a means for you to move further ahead in life. Can you change your attitude to begin with? Can you tell yourself that this exam is not some sort of a monster coming to gobble me up and push me down? It is my passport to success. As you grow up, you want to drive a car or ride a motorbike. What do you need? You need a license. For that license, what do you have to do? You have to go and pass an exam, a driving test. Do you run away from it? It's optional. You don't have to do it. But you will ask for it. You will say, I want to go and give that exam till I get that license to be able to drive my car. Look at all your academic exams also that way. Every time you pass an exam, it is like a license that you are getting to move on. So you know, when your attitude becomes positive, it is wonderful to see how you will actually look forward to every exam instead of running away from it. Now, as I said, a few simple tips. How do you face the exams? As the time for the exams is coming closer and closer, start resorting more and more to notes, bullet points, those sort of things. Because what will happen, you'll have this huge portion and you'll have very little time. So if you start reading a textbook, you've got a textbook which is 200 pages, 300 pages, you start from the beginning to the end, it'll take you 1 week just to read one textbook. You won't have time for that now. So cut it short. Start making notes, start reading bullet points, start highlighting in your book and do that sort of thing. Along with that, let me tell you something very, very important. You know what happens is, we look for ways and means, hey, my concentration is not good, my memory seems to be failing me and stuff like that. I'll give you just two simple free tips. There are two things free in this world, you know that? One is air and one is water. And they are our greatest supports to increase our concentration and our memory. Do deep breathing. Just sit down and do some deep breathing. Before you sit down, start off with studies, sit and do some deep breathing, slow and deep breathing. Air is free. And when your lungs get filled up, your ability to concentrate improves. The same way, since most exams happen to come in summer and then there's this dehydration and stuff like that, keep a nice bottle of at least 2 liters of water and keep sipping it as you keep studying. Now, when we talk about studying, where do you study? If you are studying in a room where there's a TV, or if you're studying in a room where people are walking past all over you, it makes a difference. You're not going to be able to concentrate. Forget about that. Even if you're studying in a room where in front of you, there's a window there, and outside the window, there is traffic going past. Every now and then, your eye goes to it. Hey, that seems to be a nice, interesting car, man. That's how you get distracted. Stress, we were talking about getting tense and all that. If I am sitting over here facing this direction and I've got a huge light on top of me, what's happening? The light is hitting my eyes directly and I won't even realize 1 hour, 2 hours down the line what will happen. My eyes will start paining, my focus will go off, I'll start getting bored with the studies. So if I've got this huge light over there, what do I need to do? Just turn around. Sit this way and study. The bright light is now coming on my book and I'm not getting disturbed by it. Sounds, you may say, I don't study in the TV room, I study in the next room. But if the sound of the TV is coming, that's bad enough. If the smell of cooking, mama is cooking something really nice and the aroma is coming, finished, your concentration is gone. So look for whether your seat is comfortable, whether the lighting is right, whether you are getting any form of disturbance on your desk. What do you keep on your desk? Nothing except study material. If you've got a separate desk only for studies, excellent. Remove everything from it, only your study material should be there. If you don't have, let's say you study on the dining table, doesn't matter. Get one small tablecloth, which will be used only when you're studying. So you know what happens, your brain starts connecting that tablecloth to studies. So remove everything else which is connected with food, put that tablecloth, put your water bottle, put your pen and pencils, put your rough notebook, put your textbooks, and now you are in that environment for studies. Once you start doing that, let me give you a few tips towards the last days as the exams come closer. The method of how you are going to study out of all these subjects and out of all these textbooks and so many chapters. Here you are. Take a, what do you call it? A big chart paper or a huge ledger book or something of that sort. List down. Let's say we are talking about any particular subject. And this subject has got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 chapters. Okay, let's list them down. Each of these chapters, break them into sections. Let's say chapter 1 has got 3 sections. Chapter 2 has got 2 sections. Chapter 3 has got 5 sections. Break them up into that. Review the whole textbook. Have a look at chapter 1. Go to this first section and ask yourself, do I know it very well? Have I studied it so well that I know everything about it? Write an A against it. Use a pencil to write it, okay? The second one, yes, I know everything about that part of it also. Write another A here. The third one, third part of this chapter, not very sure, it keeps slipping my mind. I do know, but not completely. Write a B. Second chapter, B. Third chapter was very tough. Nothing went in my mind. Not able to focus. I've read it once, twice. Nothing is going in my head. I'll write a C. Now you have one cursory glance and you will see that you'll have A's, you'll have B's, you'll have C's. All with pencil, mind you. Now today I want to sit down and study. Exam is coming close. What do I do when my mind is fresh? When I'm alert? I will read only the C sections. Because those are the ones that I don't know anything about. Then as I am getting tired, I will read the B parts. Few minutes before I have to end up with my studies, I'll browse through the A's and close the chapter. Next time when I start to study, I may realize that this one, I know something about it. Take an eraser, remove this and put a B here. Here you may realize that I know everything about it. Take an eraser, remove the B, make it into an A. As these C's change into B's and B's change into A's, your own spirit will go up. You'll see your progress and you'll know with very limited time which one to study and which one not to study. And lastly, when the exam has actually turned up and if you still have one or two C's left over, don't touch them. Because if you haven't been able to master this fourth chapter over a year, you won't do it on the last day. Only it will pull you down thinking, oh my God, when I open this fourth chapter, I realize there's nothing that I can do. I've still not been able. So just ignore it. Only study or revise B's and A's and go for your exam. Just before exam. That's the time when you need to be alert, you need to be fit, you need to be awake, you need to be bright. But you know what many of us do? We start cramming last minute. I won't sleep, tomorrow is an important exam. That's the day when you need sleep more. Maybe an hour or so you can cut down, but not more than that. That's the time when you need nutrition. Hey Ma, don't disturb me, I don't want to have dinner, I'm very busy studying. No, that's the time when you need dinner. That's the time when you need to have a bath so your body becomes fresh. That's the time when you need to have time on your hands. If your exam is going to start at 9 o'clock, be there at 8 o'clock. Very comfortable, very relaxed. Sit there, enjoy the nature, enjoy the fresh air, do some deep breathing. Don't sit and talk to your friend about, hey, did you mug up that fourth chapter, man? What about this seventh chapter, man? Don't get into all those discussions. Go for the exam, look at the paper, mark out those which you know, start off with those things which you know very well, and then keep those which you don't know to the end. The moment you finish with the exam, come out, close the question papers and keep it away. Don't discuss it with your friends. Take a break so that you have an, you know, you sort of erase whatever you studied about that subject. Take a nap, go out for a walk, do something nice, relaxing and recreating, and start afresh for your next paper. Before you know it, all your exams will be over. You would have moved on to a better phase of your life. Best of luck.